My husband and I used to serve in the two-year-old classes in the preschool department at First Baptist.
Well, that grows with them, and as they get on up to elementary school, we're going to need to be talking about some of those basic concepts of the gospel.
K-5.
So now Adam and I work in the children's church department for kindergarten through fifth grade.
Welcome to 252 Kids.
Obviously, Sunday mornings are our largest need for volunteers. We have a curriculum called 252.
It's our opportunity to get in, get the kids excited. So we're singing songs, we're dancing, we're playing games. That's a time to show them the joy and the excitement that can come with having a relationship with Jesus.
So when you tell those stories with excitement, the kids just sit spellbound. And they don't sit long, so obviously you're going to have to be able to get your story in and to tell it to them.
Stories like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who were thrown in a fiery furnace.
What?
It's in there. Look it up.
Everything that you are needing to lead your class is provided for that around that 9:30 hour. But at the 8 o'clock and 11 o'clock hour, we also have curriculum for that. So you don't have to come up with something.
You just read the script, you familiarize yourself with it, and then you teach it to the children.
I'm actually seeing some of the two-year-olds that we've taught before. Now they're in kindergarten and first grade, and it's great because I have an awesome relationship with them already.
When we can start sharing these things then, and it makes their mind begin to wonder and to ask questions, then working towards the time when they will accept Christ as their Savior.
Those of you who say Sunday morning, I'm already involved in a life group. Amy, I'm already in the choir. I don't have that opportunity.
Wednesday nights, Awana, they definitely need volunteers for that. The trunk or treat, pancakes and pajamas, and then Vacation Bible School is a huge undertaking where we need lots of volunteers.
People just listening to verses, people who want to come and help with games.
If you would just be the person that says good morning, just greet them, bring them in, show them the classroom to go to, that makes people feel so at home, and you can be a part just by doing that.
And obviously, getting involved will give you more and more courage to do more and more things, to step out in faith. We need dads to be involved. Your children need you. Parents, we need grandparents. How we're going to change the world, how we're going to get the gospel out around the world is to impact that next generation.
Stop by our table on Main Street or visit us online at fbcit.org/serve.